We enjoy a chili crab every now and again. It's a bit of a regional delicacy, and it uses mud crabs, which have thick, hard shells. Of course, the shells are no match for us. We've got mighty tools like the nutcracker. Alright, we can definitely do better. Then I saw a video on YouTube by Bobby GFL, where he talks about his homemade stone crab cracker.
And it just crushes it with very little force. Crush.
I want one, so let's make one. Let's get cracking. First, I made a CAD model of the thing. This compound lever has a mechanical advantage of over 10 times. A nutcracker could maybe do a measly 2 times. For this project, I chose to use the hacksaw, even though my miter saw would have made quick work of the aluminium bars. Honestly, I don't even know why I did that. I decided to use stainless steel for the lever arms so they'll survive the fight against the crab shells. Since I don't have a miter saw blade for ferrous metals, the hacksaw actually makes sense here. I don't trust myself to make a square cut, so I made a jig with my 3D printer, which really helped. There was a lot of sawing involved, and I really should have used my miter saw. There was also a lot of drilling, and I'm lucky I don't have a hand drill. I used a center drill first, then bored out the holes to their final sizes. For drilling stainless steel, I just used water as a coolant. I had to bend 2 of the aluminium pieces, so I made rough marks on where the bending regions needed to be. Before bending, I wanted to anneal the bars so they wouldn't crack while bending. I put soot from candles onto the bars as a low-tech temperature sensor. I've also got the high-tech temperature sensor. I lost the footage of the soot burning off, but at least I've got a thermal camera footage. We're aiming for 400 degrees Celsius or so, which will take a while. I sped up the process by using a butane torch. After leaving the pieces to air cool, we can crack on with the bending. I abused my mini vise for this, but managed to get a decent result. I then did a quick test fit to mark the locations of the last holes. The metal bits are mounted onto a cutting board, so I marked the mounting holes onto the bottom side of the cutting board. It's a polyethylene board, so I skipped the center drill and went straight for the counter ball. I also used a drill bit collar to set the depth. One of these holes has to take the full force of the compound lever, so I wanted to use a washer to reduce the stress. The counter board hole wasn't big enough though, so I marked the rough size of the washer and just routed it out by hand. The corners of the flat bars needed to be rounded, so I printed a small template to mark the radiuses. Grinding the corners of my mini bench grinder was crazy slow, so I sawed the corners off to speed things up. It still took ages. I needed some custom bolt lengths, so there's a last bit of sawing involved. I cleaned up the cut using a drill and a diamond file, and it's finally assembly time. I don't have a chili crab for demonstration, so I'm using walnuts instead. It works effortlessly, and the control is impeccable. That's all I have for today. This was just a quick build video, but I hope you've enjoyed it. And if you did, please consider subscribing.